The reality TV star president did all he could to cancel this particular episode, but today, reality is exactly what caught up with Donald Trump as he made the long, ignominious journey through the city that made him to hear the opening arguments in the criminal case against him.
Meme Ranch.
What's up, everyone? It is 4:31 here on the East Coast, and we're doing something a little bit different today. I got my backpack strapped on, and we're going up to New York City to see the grand old Trump trial.
What's going on right here should never be happening. It's a very, very sad day in America, I can tell you.
In the hush money case. So let's go check it out. Hopefully I can make my train on time. My Uber is on the way. I called Ubers for this trip because I have a really narrow cutoff time. Not only that, but I have to go pick up a press pass, which is going to take more time, and they only open at 9 o'clock. So whether I actually get into this trial is a little bit on thin ice. We made it. Just gotta find my Uber now, because we're not taking the subway. We made it. Here at City Hall, picking up my press credentials. It's very quiet in here. I don't even think anyone is here right now yet. So I'm just following these signs that say, pick up my press pass. So we'll see. Fingers crossed we get in. There's a lot of people outside the trial today. All right, so we made it this far into the process. We have our press pass now. And the hard part is going to be trying to get into the Trump trial just before 9 o'clock, whenever everyone's been standing out in the line since about 7 a.m. I couldn't help that. My Amtrak only left at 5 a.m., so we'll see if we can get in. We're trying to go to the criminal trial. That's what we're going to stick to, and we'll readjust if we have to. So all these people right now outside the Supreme Court are here right now for jury duty. I thought that they might be interested in like seeing what's going on with Trump's bond and whether it's going to clear or not, but these people are here for a separate case for jury duty, so lots of stuff happening in the Big Apple today. A lot of people doing press for the Trump trial just out here. Nice Super 73. Always love a good e-bike. So now we're gonna try to cross the street and get around to the actual courthouse, the New York County Criminal Courthouse, where Trump is at. You can see some press all the way through there. Looks like they're waiting for Trump to arrive. We're gonna go this way. See if we can't get around front.
Hey, All right, here we are coming up on the criminal courthouse where the press and the security are in full force. We're just doing a quick stroll. Alright, so the police just let me through that barricade, so now I'm walking closer to the courthouse. As you can see, Trump, I believe, is on the 13th floor, will be on the 13th floor. Just kidding, maybe it's not 13, but it's somewhere up there in the tens. The temperature, I heard, is also pretty cold. Trump's been complaining about the cold temperature in the courtroom. I didn't bring my heavy jacket, so I might be kind of cold too. It's already kind of cold out here today. Take a little look at the media row. Might see some familiar faces. So I just want to take a minute to talk about everything that happened. I think the last shot was me entering the courtroom. Went through the first metal detector. That was quick and easy. Made my way upstairs through the old shambly elevators that kind of have a little bit of a drop whenever you step inside. It's kind of a weird feeling. Made our way to the 15th floor where there was huge line waiting to get into different rooms to watch a stream of the court proceedings. And in that line, it was around 9:30, a little after 9:30, I believe. That was whenever Trump was speaking to the press, so I could kind of hear it faintly, not getting all of his words exact whenever I was trying to listen in. But then we made our way to the second metal detectors after we kind of turned the corner of that 15th floor hallway, and shortly after that I made my way through that last metal detector, went into the building, or I should say the courtroom, and we sat there and we listened to the opening arguments in the Trump trial. It was pretty surreal to see basically the 34 count indictment that was read by the prosecutors. It was also really interesting to see Donald Trump's sort of so what strategy that he was laying out. It was kind of like this is just an example of just the randomness that you'll have out here. This is the same spot where someone lit themselves on fire.
We have a man who is lit, he has set fire to himself. A man has emblazoned himself outside of the courthouse just now.
So anyways, what I was saying was, like, basically Trump is laying out a very much a so what sort of strategy for his defense. His attorneys are saying nothing about this was illegal. There's nothing illegal about NDA programs. So that's kind of where Trump's defense is sort of laying at. He's basically saying, so what about this whole hush money thing? So that was the end of today, and I'll be back here tomorrow. All right, now it's time to get some food so I can keep writing some more about what we heard today about Trump's legal defense strategy. And I think I'm gonna go to this cafe called Mon Mon or something like that, here in little Italy, because I'm looking for a place where I can sit down for a bit. I want to find one of these New York joints where they kick you out whenever you're done eating, so looking for some longevity. Look who it is! Oh, it just opens up.
I forgot my keys.
Well, it's a good thing it opened. Give me some, bro! Thanks for letting me stay here. We're back now after the long day of Trump trials here at Mark's place with his two dogs. Look at these dogs. Oh, you wanna play? You wanna play with the ball? You wanna play with the ball? You guys really wanna go out, don't you? Don't you? Oh, don't you?
Please tell me that you wrapped up. There you go. Thank you.
There we go. All right, what's up? This is day two, the final day for now of my coverage of the weeks-long Trump hush money trial. Special thanks to Mark and his dogs and his wife, Allie, for letting me stay at their place because I would be on the streets, maybe waiting in line all night with some of the people who are paid to wait all the time for these really high-profile like court hearings and stuff like that. So. Thanks to them, I was able to have a good night's rest. And yeah, we're walking up on the court again. I'll try to show you some visuals. Walking up right now on some officers who may or may not let me in. I probably need to show them my press pass. I'll get it out real quick.
Any credentials?
Yeah, it's in my backpack. Can I get it out real quick?
Sure. And this
I am on top of a man-made floating island, and this is sort of capping my short trip to New York to cover the Trump trial. And it's been quite the amazing ride. Saw some good friends. Saw some pretty interesting testimony. Getting to see Trump in the courtroom was always surreal. It was pretty interesting. I'll start walking as I explain the story. But I was today I was in the bathroom at the court on the 15th floor, and it was just during a break, and I saw the opportunity to go into the restroom. And as I was in there, it was pretty hilarious because this cop. He opens the door and he tells me, sir, don't leave, or don't leave the bathroom for now. And I realized in that moment that the reason why he's telling me that is because Trump is right outside the hall, right outside the bathroom. And for some reason, they just really don't want the press who are reporting on the trial to just crowd the halls whenever he's out there. They really just want to leave it to him and the few people manning the cameras. So it was pretty fascinating to be in that situation where you can like literally hear Trump's voice booming out the hall, and you can't go out and get to hear what he's saying. So that was a pretty interesting moment, just a kind of like a personal anecdote. So I kind of wanted to just show you guys a little window into my life, something that kind of shows what a day in the life of a reporter covering the Trump cases gets to see, and the process that we have to go through in order to get into that building. It's a privilege, you know, and as someone looking at this trial, trying to look and see the flaws in the prosecutor's case, the flaws in the defense, and the things that they're going to have to really, lawyer up against, to put it simply, you know, it was just really cool to see all of that be on display. And many people are looking at this case and they're saying there's going to be a guilty verdict because it's a New York jury. And, you know, New York's like 81 to 86% Democrat. So I think that, you know, regardless of what happens, you know, this is really just the beginning of this season, this election field. And we could be heading into the summer with the number one presidential candidate for one party being a convicted felon. And that would be quite historic. And there we are. We just kind of walked under one of the elevated island things. You can see it growing bigger in the distance. If you look at this from a bird's eye view, the entire structure that we were just standing on is just kind of like a giant square. It just looks like a giant square from a plane's perspective. So you might be able to kind of see that shape form as I show you the edges. As I edge, we're edging right now. But yeah, look at this.